Okay, going off to check out the arroyo and see what happened with the rain that we had last week. Gotta start walking down this slope here, but you can see everything is nice and green. Looks beautiful. Anyway, slowly down this over here. Doesn't look too bad. Well, coming up to the first stream crossing. Haven't seen water in here all year long. Doesn't look too badly washed away. It looks like, yeah, the water caused this tree to crash. And this is where a lot of water comes screaming down this hill over here, and it just keeps going this way, and so a lot of debris. Gotta climb over all of this. Yeah. Well, this used to have a lot of sand over here so the horses could ride, and it all got washed away. They're gonna have to replenish that, I guess, if they want the bridle path to be restored. Well, like, the bridle path is all washed away. Kind of hard to just walk on these rocks also. Should have brought my hiking stick. Well, this is Spook Canyon again. This is trying to see how high the water came up. You can see the trail picked up right over here, but this is all just washed away. Okay, now back up to the trail. That's a little above the creek. So this area here is okay. Yeah, okay for a little bit. And then washed out again. Still going. Everything looks nice and green though. Okay, continue, can walk now. You can see down below a lot of debris. You can see how high the water must be rushing. You can see like how the branches and bushes have been knocked down. But a nice day. So here is a drain that actually works and saves the erosion. We'll see a little bit further on where the drain is all clogged up and just does havoc on the trail. Yeah, we're way above the arroyo now, the creek, and there's all the Bridlewood homes up there on top on Ridge Drive. This is kind of a pretty spot. I like the way all those palm trees are all lined up in a row over there. Still going. And the creek is way down there. Wish they would have built the trail high above the creek to begin with. Wouldn't have to run into this erosion problem every year. Yeah, this is the drain I was talking about. It's all clogged up. You can see it's a nice big pipe, and it supposedly empties out here, but it's all clogged up, and so all the water just runs down here and just erodes everything. So it just keeps going down here and eroding. That was probably like a water trough or something like that. That used to be standing on level ground here years ago, and then over the years just the erosion wound up having that thing collapse. There's a beautiful grove of sycamores. They like it down here where it's nice and wet. So I can see there are hoof prints over here, so some horses have come down here. And what is this? Somebody took their shoes off. Okay, walk barefoot on this, whatever. Anyway, the creek is down there. I'm hoping you can hear it. Love these oak trees. They've been here for a long, long time. Okay, leaving the Bridlewood Trail and then joining up with the Santa Rosa Trail. See here, these guys, they did a good job. There's this double pipe over here, and so the drainage from the hills over here doesn't cause that much damage or erosion. And they put a lot of sandbags and things along the way. Well, it looks like the sandbags didn't really help, but maybe, yep, you can see water went right over them. Coming up to my favorite spot along the trail here. I'm glad to see water in here. Finally, this year was really totally dry, and that's the first time that was dry in like in the 30 years or so that I've been coming here. So glad to see it. But you can see all the debris kind of washed up. Gotta try and get across this thing somehow without falling in. Well, I made it across without falling in. Yeah, the fields are beautiful when they're green. Pretty soon we'll have wildflowers. Gotta come back and take a look at the wildflowers. Looks like the water breached the trail over here, but didn't do too much damage. The main part of the stream is still over on the other side over here, where these trees are. Yep. Water was rushing through here. Caused some of these trees to collapse. Okay, so now we're by the vineyard. And this is quite spectacular. Just a lot of grapes over here. Just keeps going and going. Yep. And then we come to our next attraction. Let's see, I don't see the turtles. Usually the turtles are out and about here. There's a peacock. Here's some more peacocks. And there are goats up there. And so I'm not sure exactly what this guy's trying to do, but he's always doing something with all the dirt and things. I don't know, maybe making the road a little wider or something. I don't know. Anyway, this is kind of interesting over here. Yep, there are the goats. And there's a donkey. You just swing around and take a wide view of this area here. It's always interesting to see what's happening here. It's always something different. Yeah, I don't know, there's a bulldozer over here. Looks like there's a retaining wall going up over here. Not sure what all this is going to result in. Anyway, so there's a deep gully that the water carved out. Now we're coming up to the flood wall that I guess the county built several years ago, but I don't think they needed to worry about the flood that we had last week, because they can close that off and make sure the water doesn't run into the arena, that area there. that's kind of the end of this trail. And here we are at the Santa Rosa Arena. Well, the arena looks in good shape. Didn't look like sand got washed away. Well, just came out of the trails on Rancho Santa Rosa, and then I'm going to join up with the Bridlewood trail a little further down. Okay, rejoining the Bridlewood trail off Padera. Let's see how this trail survived. Yeah, this portion of the trail is looking pretty good. Yeah, so this part of the trail looks like it's pretty good. There's a little bit of a washout, some sand. Okay, picking up the Bridle trail. Again, this is now off Vista Arroyo. Okay, moving right along over here towards the dam. Let's see how this worked out during the rains. Well, it looks like the dam held out here, not like the Oroville Dam. I would have liked to have seen this thing when it was full of water last week. But you can see the pole here. So it went above the pole and then into this overflow area here. So that's pretty cool. Yep, so a lot of debris, a lot of things, even a baseball. That's how high the dam is. I guess they were anticipating a lot of water. Well, looks like we have the Grand Canyon of the Bridlewood here. A lot of erosion. That's the access from Vista Arroyo over there. It's all washed away. And you can see this big lot of erosion there. And there we are, back at the dam. Yep, just... This isn't the way the stream is supposed to flow. It's supposed to flow over there, but it breached the banks and then came down here onto the bridle path and washed things away. Continuing Bridle Trail, Bridlewood Trail. This is the one off Vista Grande. Trail here looks in pretty good shape. So here's another Grand Canyon of the Bridlewood, and glad to see that water's running down. When I first started hiking these trails, this area here, the water was level with the ground, and so over the years it has just eroded, but it's kind of nice. Keep going. This stream is runoff from the Butterfield Stagecoach Springs, which were over there by the Santa Rosa School. Stagecoach used to stop there because there was a spring. So sometimes there's water here year round, except last year. Yeah, the trails are good if we're above where the water is. Well, just kind of made it to the end here. And let's go check out how the arena did. Well, it looks like the Bridlewood arena here is in really good shape. It looks like they've raked it and put things, toys for the horses to jump over. So that's it for the walk.